Greetings, welcome to Retro Music Review UK. My name's Roger Swift. This is a YouTube channel where I take songs from the past, play them on old-fashioned equipment, and talking to a camera while I'm playing them, talking all over them, and telling you what I think about them. Now, it's been a while since my last video. The last video I did with a friend, a comedian friend from the stand-up comedy circuit, and ever since then, it's kind of like I enjoyed that so much. I've been trying to hook up with other comedians to do these videos. There are more coming. There are more who have agreed to do them, but it's when we meet paths, when paths cross, and I have a camcorder with me and all that stuff. So that's why this has been a while. So I'm back on my own again today in the normal place on the normal camera. Been such a long time since I recorded one on this camera. It actually had dust on it. I've just had to polish all the dust off the camera because it's permanently set up here behind my desktop computer. Anyway, so I'm going to do a video at long last. Now, I'm 37 years old today. It's my birthday. Happy birthday, me. Now, what I'm going to talk about today is I'm going to do something I've not done on the channel before after a long gap, is I'm going to do two songs. But what I'm going to do is they're cover versions, it's a covers. I'm going to do the original and then a cover, back to back, and tell you what I think and which one I prefer and why. And the two songs, the original and the cover, we're going to compare today is we're going to compare John Waite's Missing You from 1984 with Tina Turner's cover of Missing You from 1996. This is one I happen to have both. I have the single of both, i.e. this is 1984, it's on a 7-inch vinyl, 1996 on a CD single. Now, I have to confess, they are John Pearson. I have to confess, I've said it again already, this one I heard first. I heard this version of it first because I was 13 when this came out and I didn't hear this one until later on. So, obviously, I have to admit, off the bat, I kind of prefer the Tina Turner one because it's the one I heard first and was the most used to. Although, having said that, I don't know, actually. But we're going to play them both and tell you what I think. Now, John Waite was an English guy, but this was a bigger hit in America, as I understand it. I've checked the Book of Hit Singles. 1984, this was a number 9 hit in the UK. Now, I was only 1 year old at the time. So, I only heard it later on, through like later after hearing the Tina Turner one. So, my memory of this is I remember seeing the music video for it on Top of the Pops back in the day, 1996, and liking the song a lot. I only later found out it was a cover and then saw the music video for this on VH1 about a year later and thought, oh, it's a cover. I didn't realise it was a cover version. This is a pre-internet world we're talking about here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop them both on. So I've got my all-in-one, crappy all-in-one here. The audio is not going to be great on this. As always said, audio files who are listening, you can F off, okay? It's not about that, this channel. So we're going to, I've got my vinyl record turning here. So I'm going to pop the record in. Now it actually says EMI America on this. Even though I picked this up in a charity shop, I was hunting in a charity shop. I think it was Stoke-on-Trent I went to, which is near where I live. Well, a couple of, you know, about 30-odd miles, 25 miles. And I found a rack of 12-inch vinyls, and I picked this one up, and I think I only paid 50p for it. Even though now I've got inside, it actually does says EMI America on it. So this could actually be the American import. It even says EMI America on the sleeve there. I'll talk about the sleeve first of all. It's a very stereotypical 80s / early 90s look, where it's just the artist in pose, like I say, trying to look very serious and like, you know, this is my very serious composition, I'm a very serious pop star. The 80s always had that look about it. The back is just again him, and you know, this is what they did nowadays. Of course, physical media doesn't really exist, so this is the kind of thing I miss, this whole artwork and stuff. So we have Missing You, written by John Waite, and then we have the B-side, which is called For Your Love. Not going to play that. So, and that was a common trope of artwork from the 7-inch 80s era, where you had the artist and then down the side, loads of them from the 80s, even into the early 90s, you get that they had that thing going on. Quite a few that are like that, with the artists, like, you know. Anyway, so let's get the vinyl record on. You're going to hear some crackles. So here we go. So, John Waite, Missing You. The crackles of the record. So, straight away, I think it needs more bass. No, bass is turned up all the way. So, it's quite a crisp production. There's quite a lot of good production there, values. Whenever I hear vinyl, I can't help but hear the crackle because I'm a CD man myself. So, I'm always going, crackle, crackle. Why did you get... Anyway. Okay, it's a very serious production values. You know, he's clearly well produced. Has got that homemade sound to it. Lyrically, this is not a love song. to get into that lyrically. This is about obviously a breakup. He's broken up with his girlfriend, and he's very, very bitter and twisted, and saying, you know, I hate you now, and I almost wish you were dead. That's basically what the song's about. I try and keep talking ever as much as I can to avoid copyright strikes, but even then, YouTube picks them up. So the guitar kicks in. It's very 80s, so it's like, you know, the synthesizers as well as car. It's adult contemporary pop, I wouldn't call this rock. Yeah. Very precision drums. Very catchy though, I like it, yeah. I like the song. Sorry, I'm entranced by the needle going round. I prefer CD to vinyl, to keep repeating myself, but I mean, watching a vinyl go around is quite good though. This is weird to me because I was so used to hearing a Tina Turner, a woman, screech it. Hearing a, you know, a man singing a bit more softly. Hers is harder, she sings a bit more harshness to it. Like, she sounds like she means it more, and her spoiling it for the little, but hearing a man singing a bit more softly, still a bit weird to me, because this is like, you know, this is like the prequel to me. This is like listening to the prequel, yeah. See, it's that lyric there, sending out a message by telegraph to your soul. He's basically saying, I wish you were dead. And it kind of builds up, you know, it gets a little bit more aggressive as the song goes on. It's this bit at the end I really like, when it's the end refrain that's coming now. This bit. That bit's really good, and the Tina Turner one is even better, I think. This bit of the song. Okay, he's starting to feel a bit more bitter now. He's starting to feel a lot more bitter in this. It takes to the end of the song before you really start feeling his resentment. Now this one just fades out at the end, whereas the Tina Turner one actually, she adds her own refrain at the end. It's a bit different, like her own outro to it. It just fades away here. Although this is the 7-inch single edit, the radio edit, so obviously it fades out quicker. But I bet you by the album that goes on for a bit longer, although I've never heard it. So there we go, that was John Waite and Missing You from 1984. Now, and I can't tell you much about the guy, other than the fact I know he was English and he had more hits in America. English musician, but he lived in America and was bigger in America than he was here in the UK. So let's now go on to the Tina Turner cover version from 1996. Reflecting the camera back in the CD single case there. I picked this up on eBay. I won it in an auction. I paid, I think, 30p for it. Well, I think I paid 30p and £1 postage. So it was like £1.20, 99p postage. So it was like £1.29. So here we go. The artwork's pretty basic. That's not a lot going on here. Now, I get the impression, as I understand it, this one was not a hit in America. She only released this in the UK. This was one of the ones that didn't come out in America. So internally, you've got a nice shot of her leg there. Of course, she was, I think, was she in her late 40s or 50s, even then in 1996 when this came out. So it's the tracks are Missing You Edit. Oh, maybe it's the edit then. The Difference Between Us, Whatever You Want, and Missing You Alternative Mix. I did own this back in the day, but I didn't buy it at the time. I went into, remember the Woolworths bargain bins? You used to go to Woolworths and then stuff that I fought out the chart, they had like a bargain bin of stuff you could pick up. And this is one of them ones I went in one Saturday and picked up with me paper round money at the age of about 13 at the time. And picked it up, I think it would have been for £1. I think 99p I paid for this. So I paid more getting it back again off eBay these 20 years later. So I'm going to put it in the CD player now. We have to change it from vinyl to CD on here and pop it in. Artwork-wise, it's a very basic setup there. It's just a gold disc with the writing on it. So not a lot to say really there when the tray decides to open. So here we go. Now this is automatic. It starts playing them automatically. You don't have to press play the CDs. Now it's actually 1996 copyright, and yeah, it's written by John Waite. Says it again there. Here we go. So straight away they've gone for a different production sound. I need to turn it up a bit. Oh, she's in quick. It is the edit, it's the radio edit. I always catch my breath, and I'm still standing here, and you're miles away. She's got a very distinct voice, Tina Turner. I've always said she's got a very distinct voice. See, she's most famous for What's Love Got to Do with It and all these other ones, but this is actually my favourite song. This is my favourite Tina Turner song. It doesn't appear on Greatest Hits compilations ever, this one. Any compilation I've ever found is like the best of all the Greatest Hits. She's done several of them. This song's never on it, which is why I've got the CD single. I like that synthesizer sound that's going on in the background. Straight away she's really putting the anger in. I like that that sound effect. You've got that ying 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 synthesizer going through it. And that's a nice touch. The background vocal of "Missing You", that works really well for me. I mean, it is a cover, as I said, you know, it's the same song. She hasn't changed the lyrics or anything. And then, like I say, to repeat myself, you have to understand, I didn't realise this was a cover. I listened to this at the age of 13, bought it in the charity shop and was listening to it, not aware that it was a cover version, until about a year later. Now the drums are kicking in, here we go. And now it gets a bit more rocky. See, the original doesn't do that. This when you get to this second chorus, it knocks it up a notch a lot more than the original does. She really starts to shriek in a minute though. It's a little bit cringy, but I like it. I was half really enjoying it, half cringing slightly at it. Do you think in her head she's thinking about Ike Turner in her head when she sings it? Really build to crescendo at the end of the song here. Do you think she's talking about Ike in her head when she's doing this? In her head, she's singing about Ike, you think? Ike Turner? And it gets more and more aggressive as she goes. Let it out, Tina. I like how there's an extra bit at the end of this that's not in the John Waite original. Now, I don't know if this is something that Tina herself added on, or whether it's just only on the album version with the John Waite one, and the radio edit fades it off, because I've only ever heard the radio edit. Here she adds an extra bit on the end, this sort of extra outro bit, which I think is really good. This really worked well, brings it to a nice end. It's a nice little ending to it, that. I like the way that ends. And just sort of fades off nicely there. So that was Tina Turner's Missing You and John Waite's Missing You. I've been Roger Swift. This has been Retro News Review UK. Please hit subscribe for more videos. They are coming, including some with guest comedians from the comedy circuit.